Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So in today's video, I try 5 different masks from Biotique which I've never tried before. So if you are interested, then please keep on watching. So the very first mask that I tried was Biomimetica Spot Correcting Anti-Acne Face Pack. Now with this one specifically, I found it a little bit difficult to apply because this is on the thicker side. I've actually left in the clips without, increasing the speed or anything so that you can see how easy or difficult it was to apply. And secondly, I did feel tingling sensation almost immediately after the application, so I didn't really mind it. If you have super sensitive skin, it can be a little problematic for you. And it almost dried down very quickly, which was a very good thing, because who wants to apply mask and wait for like 15-20 minutes for it to dry, right? So that way this mask is very good, and this also has like very tiny micro beads. So now this is something which I was not super happy with, because if I want a mask, I just want it as a mask, you know, I don't want it as an exfoliant. So I don't know, like you can like it, I just personally did not really like the micro beads in it. But again, I did not really, you know, hate it. It's just that I don't like microbeads in my mask. So overall, this is how my face looked like after removing. I saw a very nice sheen on my face, which was a great thing. So overall, this mask gets a big thumbs up from my side. However, now that I've used it for more than 6 or 7 times, the way I like using it now is only on the acne area. You know, for example, I tend to break out generally on my cheeks, so I like focusing this mask only on those area. Because this is so thick, I don't really like to apply it all over my face. However, you can totally do that with this mask. This definitely is a pretty good mask. So let's talk about Biofruit Whitening Depigmentation and Tan Removal Face Pack. Can we appreciate the color of it? I mean, I at least don't own any face pack which looks like this color wise. And secondly, I do want to talk about the fragrance of it. I don't know what, I mean, I cannot really put my finger and tell what exactly it smells like, but I think it smells like fruits. That's what I'm guessing. It's not over the top, it's not overpowering, but you can still smell it. So I don't really mind the smell of it. I don't know if, I mean, it can be bothersome to a few of you, but apart from that, very easy to apply. It's not very thick, it's not very liquidy, it's just the, you know, the right consistency. You can apply it with ease, and it does dry down to you know, that hard sort of mask which the other sort of clay masks dry down to. I really like masks which dry down that way, because in my head I'm like, okay, now it's working, you know. So yeah, it also gave a very bright, fresh look to my face, which at this point I feel like all of these masks did. So I cannot really, you know, tell you, you know, the results as such, because you have to use it over time. But as a first impression, it did look, my skin did look very fresh and bright and very soft. It did look, it did feel very soft, which was again a good thing. So this mask is again amazing. Now coming to the Milk Protein Whitening and Rejuvenating Face Pack. Firstly, I think this is the first face pack that I own which looks like this. You know, it's like milky white. I love how it looks like. I love the consistency of it. It's very, I don't know, like not extremely runny, but it's really soft and silky to the touch. But anyways, let's talk about the mask itself. Now, when I first saw it, I thought it's going to give you nourishment. You know, it's one of those, it's one of those hydrating face pack. But after applying it, it's not really a hydrating face pack. However, it went on very smooth. I did not have to tug or pull at my skin to apply it because of the consistency. It's not very thick. Now, this does dry down, but it does not give you a very tight and hard feeling on the face. So yeah, it's a different sort of a mask. It's not your regular mask, but it does leave your skin very bright and fresh. So this one is definitely a good one again. Okay, now let's talk about the BioClove Purifying Anti-Blemish Face Pack for Oily and Acne Prone Skin. Now, when I was applying this, I just found it very similar to their Bio Mirastica face pack. Have you guys tried both of these? Do you feel these are similar? Because I did. But let's just talk about this alone. Now, this was again a little difficult to apply because of how thick it was. And it did feel a little bit tingly on my skin after applying it, which is why I think I found those two very similar. However, I have to say that the Bio Mirastica one does tingle a little bit more. Like that one tingles every time you apply it. With this one, the tingling is very mild. So I guess if you have more sensitive skin, this will be a better option for you. And yeah, it dried down very quickly. I think all of these masks dry down very quickly, which is a great thing because you don't have to sit and wait for a longer duration. And here is my skin after washing it off. Again, very bright. It looked very clean. All of these masks, I mean, at this point, I can like tell you that most of the masks give you this sort of effect. So this is something that you have to use over time to really tell the difference, but this is how my skin looked like. So this one is again good, but I don't think you require this as well as Bio Mirastica. I think you can get away with either of these because I found these very similar. However, if I had to choose, I would still choose the Bio Mirastica one because I think that works better on my skin. Now we have with us Bio Papaya Revitalizing Tan Removal Scrub. Now, I know that I'm cheating a little bit with this one because this is not technically a mask. I don't know how I ended up buying this because I was only looking for masks. But anyways, now that I have it, I did use it as a mask, you will see in a while. Now, of course, I'm going to judge it as a scrub and not as a mask. So I hope you don't mind it. But what I did was I just wet my face, as you can see right here, and then I went over with the scrub. Now, if you are someone who likes a physical exfoliant, then you will like it. However, I have to say that now that I've switched to a more gentle and mild exfoliant, this was not my favorite. It just depends on you because the beads are quite, like there on your face, like you can really feel it. I did try it as a mask in the sense that I just applied it on my face and then I left it on for like 15 minutes just to see how it really works as a tan removal scrub, but here's my skin after washing the mask. I don't know if I really saw a huge difference with tan and everything because right now I don't think I have very noticeable tan. So again, this is something I'll have to use over time, but as a scrub, this was not my favorite. So that's about it. Those were all the five, well, four actually masks that I've tried from Biotique. And this was my first impression. Now, my favorite has to be Bio Mirastica one, Milk Protein one, and then the Bio Fruit one. Bio Clove also comes after that, but these three have to be my favorite. And that's about it. If you have tried it, let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. And I will see you in my next video. Bye bye.